young, I was a kid, I was a baby, and I was a boy. I didn't have a father in my life. My father went to Vietnam, and when he came back, my father was addicted to drugs. In the 70s, he was addicted to drugs. This is Red Ribbon Week, and we're talking about drugs, but I don't think it's nothing that I can teach you guys about drugs. It's nothing I can tell you that the streets are not already telling you, or that your peers are not telling you, or that TV, in fact, is not teaching you. It's nothing that I can teach you about that. But I'm going to talk to you about the impact of drugs. 1970, man, a 17-year-old girl is raising a boy in the streets of Kansas City. I'm from Kansas City, Missouri. Anybody ever been there? I'm from 33rd and Ashley. It's the metropolitan part of Kansas City. It's what they consider the ghetto, the slums, the hood. It's where I was born and raised. And people think that living in a place like that, you think that you don't have things, you have a lack of things. And I thought that I had everything. Because I had a grandmother and a grandfather who raised me. Because their daughter was too young to raise me. So I kind of had like three parents. I had my mom, I had my grandmother, and I had my grandfather. Anybody here relate to that? Who loves their grandpa? Their grandma. Yeah. We all need something from somebody to validate who we are as human beings. It's a natural thing. It doesn't matter what your ethnicity is. It doesn't matter what your geographical location exists. It doesn't matter, man. You need to feel something at all times from other people to let you know that, hey, man, you're okay. We all need to feel that. And see what happens when you got that secret. I was walking around with that secret. I didn't want to tell anybody, but I wanted to protect that secret. So I found football, man. Football was my first outlet. But guess what? I'm not coping with what's wrong with me. I'm just playing football.